Working on a 77 Chevy Love. Getting ready to pull carburetor intake, so I'm going to make me a video so I know how I put it right back together. A lot of people don't think about doing that, but it can't be helpful. So, let's see what we can do here. We got on this side of the carburetor, this left line goes to TVS switch. It goes to one of the two that's on the lower intake manifold. The other TVS, since we're there, follow it down. It goes to the crankcase. I believe it goes to the crankcase. So, goes to the yar valve, way down in there. You can see my fingers in there now. So this one here goes to the sensor on the intake manifold, TVS I believe it's called, and then the other one that goes to the EGR valve. Excuse me. So second one here, that goes to the distributor vacuum advance. It just does leak them all. Buy a long one and just trim it down as it gets used and wears out. Looks like I got my distributor cap all marked. So leave them all marked. Follow it to the other end. Everything lines up perfect. So this braided hose goes to the bottom of this canister thing here. That's to the intake manifold, the braided hose. Maybe you don't have a braided hose, but anyway, underneath the carburetor, off the outside of the intake, goes to this guy here. By the way, this is a smog car, so if you're wondering what this stuff is. And that hose goes over to the other side. So, back to the car. They got two electrical lines here. Harness from the car. Black with a white stripe, and the other is black with a yellow stripe. And they are matching wires on the carburetor. They go to your choke. One goes to your choke. The black and white goes to the automatic choke. The other one goes to the anti-desling valve. They both come through right to here. Got vacuum diaphragms here and here for the choke. They tee off of here, goes out, tees up, goes one to each. And that vacuum gun goes into the carburetor there, creates its own vacuum, feeds it back to operate these things. And you got this other two wires off that same harness. You got a solid black and a solid blue. No stripes on either. And they go to this unit. Now, this is the anti-desling. I'm not sure what anti-desling valve, solenoid valve, solenoid. I don't know, both of them are solenoid, I don't know. Look it up in your book. We got a piece of gasket hanging out over here. That's never no good. So we got vacuum lines that go to the bottom down there. There's three. two side by side, one a little lower. So side by side, let's go to the back one. Goes to the air cleaner. I know that because I disconnect right here all the time just to leave all that connected. And I leave an elbow right here. The front one goes to the crankcase ventilation for the vent right there. Third one, which is the lower one, it goes to the T. Goes also to that canister right there. And the other one tees off and it goes to the other side, which is that unit. Right now I couldn't tell you what that is. Have to look it up. I don't keep track of it, I gotta keep a book. We got water inlet on the top of the intake manifold. And I got this line goes to the brakes. That must create a vacuum, this port.
Nice to have an air compressor. It gets loud.
So I'm gonna take out and clean out the EGR valves. I'm taking my intake manifold off. I got smog next month, so I wanna make sure everything's all clean and breathing. I've been running with a bad exhaust, so I'll make sure the EGR's valve before I do a test. This one goes to the air cleaner too. This front one. This one here goes to the oil pan vent. This other one here goes down underneath the car. It goes probably back to the gas tank. It's probably the evaporator sensor. So that's pretty much it. Try to loosen that before you take off the intake manifold. Try to break it loose, make sure you pre-lubricate. If you do it while it's connected, it's easier to turn because the other object is not spinning and you have to hold both of them. If you have one of these glass filters in there, make sure they're not banging on nothing. I got mine nice and tight, and that's why it won't hit nothing. But they break, they hit something, and then your gas just keeps pumping and you started a fire, so just a safety thing.